Gold-digging murderer Des Campbell will spend at least 24 years in jail for pushing his wife Janet off a cliff.
10 reporter Brett Mason is in Albury for reaction from Janet Campbell's family, but first to Gabrielle Boyle, who was in court today. Gabby, how did Des Campbell react to his sentence?
Well, to be honest, Bill, Des Campbell didn't show a great deal of emotion as he heard the details of his case. The courtroom itself was packed to capacity, standing room only, around a dozen people stood. More still, members of the public were turned away at the front door. Des himself kept his eyes firmly fixed on the judge, didn't look around very much. Of course, he was told that he's 52 years old now, he won't be getting out of jail until he's at least 76 years old. Here's a little of how it unfolded in court this afternoon.
A cold, cunning and calculated killer leaves court, bound for what will most likely be the rest of his life behind bars.
I actually said to him, don't drop the soap. I'm thinking about buying exercise bikes and donating them to that prison too, I think.
For just the second time, an in-court camera captured the sentence.
That the offender took the life of an outgoing, generous, warm-hearted and somewhat naive, middle-aged country woman as soon as it became clear that he had obtained as much financial advantage as he could from the relationship.
Campbell met his future wife, Janet, while she was working at Deniliquin Hospital in 2000. The pair secretly wed in 2004. Just 6 months later, the 49-year-old fell to her death in the Royal National Park south of Sydney. Campbell skipped his wife's funeral and went on holiday with another woman. But his lies caught up with him. Janet hadn't fallen while going to the bathroom. She was pushed. Last year, Campbell was charged with murder.
Within hours of her death, and I suppose just being at the scene, seeing the location, the location of the tent just didn't add up.
But the circumstances under which Janet Campbell met her death demonstrate the offender's sustained callousness towards her for nothing more than monetary gain.
Indeed, Campbell even told a relative
that she was very wealthy but, quote, pig ugly, unquote. And he did not know if he could bring himself to, quote, shag her, unquote.
How's Des coping with the news?
Well, what do you think?
Gabrielle Boyle, 10 News.
Janet Campbell's family and friends watched her killer's sentencing live online. 10 reporter Brett Mason was with her relatives in Albury.
Well, understandably, those closest to Janet Fisicaro were emotionally overwhelmed as Justice Megan Latham detailed Des Campbell's callous crimes. We watched the sentence live on the internet with Janet's sister and closest friend. They, like so many people out here, were proud to be able to watch justice be done.
And we're very happy with the outcome. And we just want to get on with our lives now and let Jenny rest in peace. The main thing for us was the guilty verdict. What he got was just extra.
Those who knew and lived with Des Campbell say they weren't at all surprised that he maintains his innocence. And even today, being sentenced to 33 years prison showed no emotion.
He's never had any emotion. He hasn't got any emotion. You've got to have a heart to have emotion. He hasn't got a heart.
After years of police investigations, coronial inquests, Supreme Court trials, verdicts, and today a sentence, the heartache for this family is not over yet. Late this afternoon, we had confirmation that Des Campbell does plan on appealing today's 33-year sentence in the Supreme Court.
Brett Mason with that report from Albury.